It's a bit like if you see a child, right, learning to walk and run and so on, right? They fall down. So the course is called Athletic Intelligence in Robotics. So here the focus is really on the movement and the sensory motor control performance of robots.
You can see this as an introductory course, right, into what do I need in order to work with robotics. Within the course, we have this four-legged dog robot that you can sort of learn how it actually works in reality, and not only in simulations or and theoretically.
The term athletic intelligence is slightly different from cognitive intelligence. So things like logic, reasoning, language, right? So that kind of stuff. So it's all a part of artificial intelligence, but we are focusing more on the low-level control of the system, where many of the actions that the robot take or we take, right, they are unconscious things related to our balance, the reflexes that we have. So we are interested in studying those principles.
You need a lot of knowledge for robotics. It's also an interdisciplinary topics, I think. So I was afraid to, you know, take the first step. But when I came to the Chalmers and I found this track course, and I think it's a great opportunity for me to get some knowledge in robotics and to do something real.
I'm very interested in the intelligent systems and the robots. I think in the future that the intelligent systems will become a more integrated part of our daily lives. So that's why I chose this major.
I had a summer job at some point and I just wanted to do something over summer really. And a friend of mine worked in a company that dealt with robotics, and then I started working on it and I wrote like some very easy code, very little, and the robot moved with my code and I was very happy. And yeah, that's how I got into it. And since then I only wanted to learn more, yeah.
In this course, so we for this assignment, we design a controller to control the robots to follow the trajectories we want, like the square and the circle or the triangles. We also consider how to model the things and how to describe the robots and how to design the policies for control the robots.
Mainly, we're trying to understand how to build the models of the robotics. So the dynamic models, how it moves, and then when we know how it moves, we can know how to be efficient with the moving. So we, with athletic intelligence, we can make it move in the most efficient way.
So one of the things that we're working on right now is to get platform up on the cloud so that students can test their own controllers and other similar stuff on an actual pendulum that we have. So that way they can connect to it from their own home, for instance, and they can use it for assignments or just testing their own personal stuff. Usually, access to these robotic systems is kind of challenging. Usually they're expensive and also hard to maintain. So by doing this, we're kind of falling back into a simpler system and also giving the students access to an actual robot, which is something that they don't usually get. Usually they're more working on simulations and these kind of things. So by that, our goal is to bring the students access to this robot that usually they wouldn't have access to. Usually when they get access to robots, it's for a very limited time, very few robots for many students, and they have to be supervised usually. So what we're trying to do with this system is to allow them to access this robot at any time and without the need for supervision, so that they can actually work on it trial and error until they sort things out by themselves.
Like a bridge, it connects the theoretical concepts and the practical applications so that you can get a comprehensive understanding of the whole things.
I think the first use cases that are already happening are in industry, so inspection, maintenance. There are many dangerous sites where we want to have less humans, for example, some offshore plant, some oil rig, some nuclear facility, right? And there you want robots to go around and monitor the areas, right, which can be dangerous for humans. And if the robots have the right agility, like humans, right, then they can do this task and save humans from that kind of thing. Such robots can be deployed for automating many tasks in industries where humans have to work in unergonomic postures, right, like carrying heavy loads. As these robots become more intelligent, I think we will see their use case in medical applications, elderly care homes where there is a lack of staff usually to help old people, for example. So I think the possibilities are endless, and I'm very excited for that future.
Through this course, I realized one thing, that that's also what the teacher said during the course, that for the robotics, the hard problems is easy. However, the easy problem is hard. For example, if you let the robots to play chess or play Go, it's quite easy, right? Now it can beat almost 99% of humans. But however, if it comes to you let the robots to do like maybe spin the pen on your hand or let it squeeze toothpaste, these kind of easy things, it's really hard. The most fun part is what we are doing right now, try to control the unitary Go to robots to follow the path we designed.
The most fun part, since we do the group works and we're from the different background, the different background people have the different point view. So we can if we collaborate with each other, we have a wide and a deeper understanding of what's going on.
The most fun thing is to actually see robots moving, and I think it's nice because like robots move a bit like natural, and then like, I don't know, writing some own code and writing some simulations where actually seeing that the equations like come alive with like movements, that's really nice.
Since I'm interested in intelligent systems, so maybe my goal is to contribute to the robotics in future. We will see.
For me, it's important to know about this, about like robots, even though I might not work with it directly, because I feel like in the future it will become more relevant. Like there will be walking robots, I will be working with walking robots. So it's good to know about it. And then, yeah, that's the main part. And maybe I will work with it even in the future, which would be nice.
I hope that the students, they not only after this course go to a traditional industry, but also think about starting their own companies and build their own robots and take this entrepreneurial perspective to bring a change in our society. So that happens a lot. And it's fine. Yeah.